One of the unique things about a bell choir is that between numbers, the director nearly always has to get up and talk a minute so that the ringers have a chance to get the bells arranged for the next number. Also gives me a chance to talk a little bit about bell ringing and the music that we play. If any of you know some Canadians, they probably would tell you that their main contribution to the Christmas celebration is the carol, "'Twas in the Moon of Wintertime." Actually, it's a French melody, and it was arranged or written, actually, for the Huron Indians in Canada. And the words are kind of neat. I'd like to read them to you. "'Twas in the moon of wintertime when all the birds had fled, that mighty Gitchimanitou sent angels' choirs instead. Before their light, the stars grew dim, and wandering hunters heard the hymn, Jesus, your King is born. Jesus is born. In excelsis gloria. Within the lodge of broken bark, the tender babe was found. A ragged robe of rabbit skin enwrapped his beauty round. Then as the hunter braves drew nigh, the angel's song rang loud and high, Jesus, your King is born. Jesus is born, in excelsis gloria. The earliest moon of wintertime is not so round and fair as was the ring of glory on the helpless infant there. While chiefs from far before him knelt with gifts of fox and beaver pelt." And that runs right into whence comes this rush of wings afar. If you listen closely, what we've tried to do is to make some of the music sound like the rush of wings.
Thank you.
I'm sure that most of you are familiar with the way bells are set up, that each ringer is assigned two letters for the most part, sometimes more, sometimes less. But that's the basic setup. I have taught the following piece to many, many bell choirs, and the reason I have used it so often is because it not only is beautiful, but it's a wonderful teaching tool in that by changing what bells they play, reading the same music, but each time that they play the piece, they play one half step higher, which means that they have to put down the bells that they played the first time and pick up the exact right bell for the next time through. We'll start it, I believe it's in the key of B flat, and then we play it in the key of B natural, then in the key of C, then in the key of C sharp. The reason I'm bringing this up is all the times that I have taught this, I thought, oh boy, I'm going to really pull a good one on this group. And so when I brought it out the first time, I explained it and thought, well, you know, this will take 15 or 20 minutes at least. Handed it out. We played it through. Not a mistake. Played it through the second time. Not a mistake. The third time, not a mistake. The fourth time, they didn't make one mistake playing it through for the first time transposing. So I was sure they had done that before, but they hadn't. That's how good they are. Could get by without having to come up here, but I don't think I can. I always am curious if, seems like, of course, you all know that I've been in San Francisco for a long time, and every time we did any kind of bell program, I was amazed that somebody had never heard a bell choir perform before. Is there anybody here tonight that's never heard a bell choir? Yes, there is. It just seems amazing, you know, because my life has been tied up with bells for so long that, and there are so many bell choirs now. When First Christian got the first bells in Arkansas about in 1960, and of course at that time, the closest bell choir was in Tulsa. I remember we invited a group down from Tulsa to kind of show us how it was done, and of course they didn't really do it right. They didn't. They played with a chart, you know, and the director stood there and pointed to the notes on the chart. And so we didn't know any better. We thought maybe that was the way it was supposed to be, but it didn't take too long to discover that wasn't the way it was supposed to be.